My name is Laure Itard, and together with Philomena Bleusen, we are going to be your teachers in the course Comfort and Health in Buildings, the third course of the Professional Certificate Program Buildings as Energy Systems. Welcome! In this course, you will learn how to ensure good indoor comfort and air quality, and how these factors relate to health, well-being, building design, and buildings' energy systems. Comfort and health complaints mean user dissatisfaction, which in turn means delays and resistance to accept technologies needed for low carbon emission buildings. People spend more than 80% of their time in buildings. Therefore, good thermal environment, comfort and quality of the indoor environment are essential for their well-being, health and productivity. Additionally, complaints about the indoor thermal environments are one of the major complaints building and facility managers have to deal with, and they spend a large amount of their time and money to solve them. So, if you want to discover what to pay attention to in your energy designs or in designing new concepts for sustainable buildings, this course is for you. Note that in the next slide, we reversed the title. Comfort and health has become health and comfort. From the perspective of building engineers, we are used to deal more with comfort than with health. But in the end, what really matters is, of course, people's health. I now give the word to Philomena Bleusen.
Hello, I am Philomena Bleusen, and I will explain shortly the weekly program of this course. In week one, you will discover what indoor environmental quality is, what it means for people's health, and how you can assess it in buildings. Additionally, in week one, two specific aspects of indoor environmental quality will be taught: lighting quality and sound quality. Then, in the second and third week, respectively, thermal comfort and indoor air quality will be the focus. With regards to thermal quality, you will learn which measurable physical parameters and combinations of parameters impact people's comfort. You will discover the two main theories of thermal comfort, and you will understand why it is difficult to create indoor environments satisfying everyone, but also which main parameters to tune to make buildings thermally comfortable. Week 3 will be devoted to indoor air quality, which pollutants we encounter in indoor environments, and from which sources they origin. You will also learn about the related health effects and what you can do to minimize indoor air pollution by source control and ventilation. Finally, in week 4, you will apply your knowledge step by step to the design of healthy and comfortable buildings, taking account of interactions between the different factors as well as energy use, including the design of ventilation and air distribution systems to avoid noise and increase thermal and air quality, and the design of energy-efficient, healthy and comfortable buildings. We hope you will enjoy this course. See you soon.